Isn't it up?
Should I?
Yeah.
I know. Yeah.
Oh, you're a genius. Thank
well,
you.
Well, you raised it a couple of times.
Thank you. Yeah, that helps. Okay, everybody smile at me.
I already signed you.
Gentlemen, Tim.
What?
Quiet.
Let me talk about that.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This work session of the Hampton Municipal Budget Committee will come to order at 7 p.m. on January 3rd, 2017. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Introducing themselves from the viewer's right, the members of the budget committee, please.
Russell Bridal, but selectman, representative.
Jenny Bridal, school board rep.
Michael Pearson, taxpayer representative.
Sonny Kravitz.
Steve Anderson.
Mike Wolf.
Danielle Augustine.
Joan saying Happy New Year to one and all.
David Moore.
Stephen LaBranch.
Maureen Buckley, representing the Hampton Beach Village District.
And our secretary is Barbara Kravitz. I have a couple of announcements and things to bring to your attention before we start. The intent is to do our final review of the articles, and here comes Brian Lapham, so that's good. We've got a full house. We want to finalize our figures now on the sections of the operating budget. But first, we were given on December 20th, and that was a busy night. None of us, I think, had a chance to look. We were given a set of the default budget pages and so forth, and I'm going to ask you to discard those. It's nice to have them, but we are not going to be using those. We're going to be using the figures from our original November 4th presentation that was made to us by the Board of Selectmen. We don't accept any adjustments from the selectmen once their original budget figures are put through. I've had calls on a question on the calculation of the fire supervisors collective bargaining contract. We did approve that when we went through the warrant articles, but there seems to be some question on the dollar amount. It seems rather high. So if one of you who voted in favor of the fire supervisor's contract want to make a motion this evening to pull it back and ask for figures, that would be very nice. Otherwise, we, I guess, could ask for figures and make the adjustment at the public session next week or the deliberative session. But I have had questions on the on what looks like an overly large dollar amount. Just so you know that.
Madam Chair, if you have questions, why don't you just ask me?
What? Well, no, that's my question. I mean, I've had...
What are the questions you have?
The question I have on the supervisor's contract is that people are calling me. I'm not a mathematical wizard.
Yeah.
But they're telling me that it appears that the dollar amount that's stipulated in that contract is too high.
Okay.
And I don't know one way or the other.
I can help you a little bit with that, Madam Chairman.
Make sure the microphone can pick you up.
Okay. When I watch the reruns, I can always hear myself. You must need a hearing aid.
No, I
but
need
anyway,
a little...
back at the ranch. When we looked at the current warrant article for the 3017 warrant article, one of the numbers in that warrant article had $448,000 supposedly at 3% over 3 years. And if you did the math on that, that's roughly 9.3% total. And if we go through and add up the numbers with 13 people, and if you use a 448, that comes out to roughly $34,000 per person for 3 years and $11,000 per year per person. So those numbers don't add up right. That's a significant increase. That's about 13 or 14% increase, which doesn't agree with the verbiage in the warrant article at all. And that's why we have the question. It's about at least twice as much as what we estimate it should be. We estimate to be somewhere in the neighborhood of 240,000. It's 448. And if you do all the math on that, like I said earlier, that would add for 13 people. With divide that into 448, that's a chunk of change. That's 34,000 per person for 3 years. I don't think that's what the warrant article intended.
Okay, if we could, Rusty, could you ask for clarification for us? And Thursday may be too soon, but at least before we get to the public hearing.
Okay.
Would you do that? That would be nice. Because if we don't want, if it doesn't warrant as high a figure, then I would think that might make the public happier, but I have no idea.
Absolutely.
Excellent. Thank you. Okay. I have advertised, as of today, our public hearing on January 12th, which is a week from Thursday, so all of you are aware. And then, as you know, I have a statement to share with you, because on December 20th, the Budget Committee did vote to hire counsel to respond to Town Council's letter to us. In accordance with the Budget Committee direction, by vote, on 12-2016, I engaged counsel to advise the committee with respect to its response to the RSA 91A request from the town's legal counsel. I have retained Brian K. Gould of Cleveland Waters Bass in Concord as our attorney, signed the engagement letter on 12-29-16, and signed the finance office retainer request form today, so the check for counsel can be forwarded to Attorney Gould. Mr. Gould will be contacting the town's lawyer to discuss resolution of his right-to-know law request and will report to us on the outcome of the discussion. We have also asked Mr. Gould if he would be willing to provide the committee with advice on other legal issues the committee must deal with from time to time, and he has agreed in principle. As you know, our budget for legal fees is limited, so we will have to determine how to fund any legal work beyond the immediate matter of the right to know law. I also need a vote from you, ladies and gentlemen, because I do have copies of the engagement letter to share with you, but it can only be made public by vote of this committee. So if you would be kind enough, someone to move that the chairman be allowed to pass out the engagement letter copies to members of the committee, I will be happy to do that. I do have copies with me tonight.
I'll make that motion.
Okay.
I haven't seen the letter, so how am I supposed to
decide? Well, nobody has seen the letter. That's why we need a vote to release it.
There's a second.
Okay, you understand?
No.
What?
I haven't seen the letter. So.
You're not going to see the letter until the Budget Committee votes to release it to the public and to the committee.
When will I be allowed to finish my sentence, Madam Chair? I haven't seen the letter, so I don't know the contents of the letter.
Well, you will.
Therefore, I cannot decide whether it ought to be made public or not.
Council said
I don't release things to the public unless I know the content.
The council said it is perfectly acceptable to release.
Well, that's great.
The engagement.
That's great, but I haven't seen the content, so I have no information upon which to make an intelligent decision on the question on the table.
You will, I promise. Okay.
Until I do, I'm voting no.
You can do whatever suits you.
Damn right I can.
In favor of allowing the chair to release the engagement letter from counsel. Okay, we have, Brian, are you voting, my dear? Yes? No. Okay, and so we have Jones and Lapham saying no, and and the rest of us are in favor. Okay, I will give those to you at the end of the meeting.
Madam Chair.
We'll each have a copy.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
Point of order.
God love us, yes.
I did not call for the noes. I did not see the selectman's representative hand goes up when the question of who was voting in favor of.
I did.
Okay, then I missed that. Sorry. But I would like a call for yeas, nays, and abstentions. going forward, Madam Chair? Yeas, nays, and abstentions.
Oh, God,
the mere fact that you don't vote in the affirmative does not necessarily mean you're voting no, which is the assumption the chair is making.
We'll be here till midnight.
If you do things correctly, that may be true.
I won't.
Okay, Mr. Bridle, Mrs. Bridle-Russell, Mr. Pierce, Mr. Kravitz, Mr. Lapham is abstaining or voting no? What are you doing?
No.
He voted no. Mr. Henderson is in favor. Woolsey in favor. Plus Augustine, and
negative.
You are negative. And then Maurer and LaBranche and Maureen. Okay.
In favor.
So we have two negatives, Lapham and Jones. Bless you. Now.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Our goal this evening is to get through finalizing the accounts for the 2017 proposed budget. I've tried to get the less controversial accounts on the schedule for tonight. What we're going to do is move the account to finalize it to take to the public hearing on Thursday, the 12th.
Madam Chair, inquiry, if I may.
Yes.
You sent out a agenda for tonight. Do you intend on making these motions in the numerical order presented in your email?
I'm going to try.
Then, therefore, I move the trustees of the trust fund for $1,000. Can I get a second, please?
Second.
Okay. Excellent. Bill,
$1,000, there's no need to discuss it,
well,
in my opinion.
Well, I'm just, but Bill and John have showed up and come here to smile at us, and I just want to
smile back.
That they're here, and the... I'm showing $1,000.
That's what the motion was, Madam
Chair.
Okay,
all right. Bill, you said $1,500 when you came in, I thought? It's just showing $1,000.
$1,500.
From where?
The trustees of the trust.
We're on the first page. You'll be
asked. $1,000.
There's no. I'm showing $570 for part-time wages and $430 for supplies and expenses.
We have a website for that.
Well, you didn't put it in your budget.
It's not. Okay, what you'll want to do, gentlemen, is adjust that at the deliberative session on February 4th. Okay? All right. In favor of...
Wait a minute, Madam Chair. The reason we have these people in is to educate us on things we don't know.
Yes.
And the gentleman is educating us on something we didn't know.
Yes.
That he's actually asking for $1,500, not the $1,000 that has been presented by the budget book that we were given by town management.
But
so, you need $500 for a website? Is that what I'm hearing?
That's a cushion.
It's a cushion. We don't buy cushions generally.
Excuse me, can we ask for the names of people who are...
I'm sorry. Bill Hartley and John Sovich, S-O-V-I-C-H.
G-I-T-L-E-Y.
Trustees.
And we don't know how many meetings we're going to have in a year, so we pay our secretary... per meeting.
Okay.
And we have four regular meetings, but we also have special meetings. And so we don't know how much it's going to be. That's why I asked for the cushion.
Can I ask you a favor? Well, can you get up the table so the speaker can hear you for the
audience? Yeah, please get to the microphone if you would.
If you would.
I understand your argument about the meeting question, number of meeting questions.
Yeah, we don't know.
But that has got nothing to do with the website you were mentioning earlier. So.
No, that doesn't.
All right, so I'm not going to think about website anymore.
Okay.
So you need another $500 to cover what you consider to be an unusual number of meetings in 2017?
Yeah, for contingency.
Okay. Budget committee people get excited when you start talking contingency, Bill. What I suggest is that you gentlemen put your heads together, because that really should have been part of the request. And at the deliberative session, you will have an opportunity, if you feel it is appropriate, to go ahead and make that motion. And it can be incorporated in the budget at that time.
So in the meantime,
a little wary since we
have... In the meantime, it's back to 1,000?
Yes.
Right now, it's sitting at 1,000.
Right now, Bill, for part-time, which is what your meeting costs out, is the part-time wages, right?
Right.
And that's right now at 570. So effectively, you're asking to double that for purposes of a cushion.
Yes.
That seems a bit excessive to me, to double something.
Well, you
just
never know.
For a cushion. Well, why not triple it? Because you never know. You know, so.
Okay.
I mean, I might be willing to go up 10 to 20% kind of thing, but 100% seems way out of the ballpark to me.
Yeah. If you gentlemen are at the public hearing on Thursday, you could also bring that up in public at that time, and then the Budget Committee will have a chance to review at the end of that public hearing. Okay?
Okay.
Well, you're both very kind to come. Thank you, gentlemen, very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Kenny, yeah. Cemeteries are next.
Wait a minute, we didn't
vote. Are we voting?
I'm sorry. That's right. Thank you. Well, we're moving. Okay. In favor of the bottom line showing in our budget printout, $1,000 for the trustees. Yeah. Thank you.
Madam Chair?
Yes, sir.
I move total cemeteries for $124,143.
A second.
Thank you.
Where are cemeteries in the OBS?
OBS 6.
OBS 6, thank you.
Mr. Kenny, good evening, and what? There you are.
Hi.
What are we doing with you? We've got a total of $124,143.
I don't know. I got this thing about January. It seems like every January my clothes shrink. And I can't put my button on why that happens. What can you do with me? Does anyone have any suggestions or anything?
Yeah, we can terminate your Christmas dinner.
I thought a little levity might be.
I thought I was adding to it.
That's all.
Choose that or the fruitcake.
But it is true. Okay.
Christy, is there an adjustment for gasoline in this? Because the gasoline sheet
that wasn't the one on 1220 that you.
I know that, okay. But what I'm saying is, you removed gasoline in some line. You confused me thoroughly with your gasoline sheet, but this is pretty clear cut. He's only got one line. Mm-hmm. So, what are you going to propose, an increase in the gasoline or the decrease?
The Board of Selectmen proposed a decrease in the gasoline.
And do you have that figure? Because right now it's showing $3,743.
The gasoline was brought down to $1,683.
Yep. Okay, so that will make his total what? I don't have a calculator.
122.083.
Yeah,
that's the default.
Oh, 122.083.
If you look in the latest one she gave me, it's 122.083.
That's when she said she has something else.
We don't, it's going to be a problem.
Right.
No, because the update is not a Budget Committee document. The one we're talking about right now is. This is one we were given.
I just want to make sure that we're making a proper adjustment for him. There it is.
And Madam Chair, when you
showed 121,843.
Yeah.
And when you asked for, when you talked about gas during your meetings,
yes,
as I was watching, that's why the finance director came up with this one in 1220, so that you'd have the
and I
corrected
appreciate
ones.
That.
That's why.
But
that's
some of the, if I recall, some of the accounts were squashed together on single lines, and it drove me crazy. But anyway, cemeteries is pretty clean cut. So we have 121.
No, that's a default. It's 122.083.
122.
083.
Oh, yeah. Excuse me, Mary Lee. Would you give me what the gas is? What is the gas?
Well,
line?
We thought the gasoline figures were high.
Okay.
And so Christy recalculated.
So what are they right now?
You're still 1683.
At 1683
for the whole year?
Yep.
I'm not even come close.
Well, your actual last year was only a little over 1,000.
Well, I'm over 2,000 already this year.
No, it's a new year, my dear. And you get, last year you spent $1,068.
But we didn't have a winter that required a
again,
lot of
water. Again, yeah,
it's raining right
you're
now.
You're talking,
so.
I'm just going to run down how much gas we use and what we use it on, and then you can consider what you want. You know, for the trucks, normal year, and as Ginny said, last year it wasn't, most of us plowing, we used 500 gallons of gasoline. For our weed whackers, we use $100 of gasoline. For our mowers, we use $500. For our leaf blowers, we use $150. For our chainsaw and our hedge clippers, we have 180 bushes that have to be trimmed either. That's another $130. So I think that comes to a little bit more than what you're giving me.
On your actual, you were showing 28.
When you purchase gasoline for your weed whackers, et cetera, do you use the WEX card to make those purchases?
Yes, I do.
So the history of those purchases are actually incorporated in Christie's calculation?
I would think so.
Right. So therefore, I would assume that Christie's calculation is accurate in terms of actual historical usage relative to gallons.
Actually,
not necessarily dollars. Right. Dollars is another question, which needs to be raised, Madam Chair, because we're going to have this gasoline discussion a lot.
Yeah.
And hopefully you just get it all resolved right now. Right now, Christie, the new number, you're suggesting a reduction of 16.83 from cemetery for gasoline, correct?
Yeah. That's okay. Based on the gallons and the
And that's
the
at
price
a gallon? That's
it.
And what was that price that you're setting at?
Yeah, but his actual, according to, is $2,852.
Yeah, well, I understand. I have to modify my motion. And I will get around to modifying my motion in a moment. As soon as I get some clarity. No, I'm asking only the per gallon rate.
I need to find the memo so that I can okay.
I thought I heard $1.95, is that right?
No, that's what it was last year.
$1.75.
Okay.
Actually, on our sheet, because I'm on the November 4th sheet, it does show his actual use through the end of September, which is the 1,068.
Yeah, but Chrissy's recent calculation was a 12-month.
I realize that.
So that calculation is
right.
Consistent.
Yeah.
She did a 12-month on her own, which was subsequently distributed.
That's another 700, roughly.
Well, I hope it just continues to rain. If this was snow, I'd have to be out plowing it. And, you know, last year I didn't get it. The year before I did. Well, so you might want to take a look at how much we spent the year before.
We made sure it wasn't snow tonight. You know, so we're doing
it's
what we
wonderful.
Can to keep the budget
well,
down.
It's wonderful. The stuff and I like, well, one of my favorite things professionally is rain in January, believe me. But that doesn't always happen.
April as well, right? Because they bring the May.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah. Poor man's fertilizer, we call it, yes. But I just think that figure is too low. If I have a normal year, last year was not a normal. Not to mention the prices were lower than they had been in the past.
Christy, you have a number?
$1.75 a gallon.
So you're projecting $1.75 a gallon for 2017, and we have 42 cents of tax that we're not paying to make it equivalent to what we see on the retail street. So that's $2.17. And right now, I just drove by a gas station. All of them said $2.27. So we're already up 10 cents over that guess.
That's fluctuating.
So I'm wondering if we're being a little too aggressive in that pricing. I mean, I love the lower gas prices, but I mean, we have to be realistic. OPEC had a meeting last month. They agreed to cut production, which is going to raise up costs. The oil stocks are projecting a higher income in terms of the stock prices. So I'm guessing that we're going to see more volatility in 2017 than we did in 2016, and that volatility is likely to be on the upward side. So,
well, we complained about the high prices when we first got the budget figures.
Well, the budgeting may have been high last year, but I'm suggesting that reality today indicates that maybe
so far off.
Well, maybe last year's number is more accurate for next year than it was for this year.
Well, we'll find out. Barbara Danny Kenny, by the way, KEN.
The numbers in the budget reflect the $1.95.
Yeah.
In the original budget, we did have the $1.95.
Yeah.
Right, okay. But your new number, right, which is a reduction of 16.
Well, we did to get our new number. We took the average price per gallon that was paid for unleaded, and we added 12 cents to it.
Right.
So we kind of added a 12 cent cushion for price fluctuations.
Yeah.
And we've already experienced more than that.
I don't disagree with everything you just said.
So I'm concerned that we're being a little.
To keep it at the $1.95, the original numbers were at the $1.95.
I wanted to be as accurate as possible. Everyone wants it to be as low as possible.
I think I can say
accuracy is more important.
I think, as far as the trucks are concerned, I think I can say we're $2,000 less this past year than we were the year before. Now, I don't know that for a fact, but if you looked it up, you'd find that.
Well, Christy can look it up. She already did the research. Is that accurate, Christy?
I mean, we used...
He's saying he used $2,000 more in gasoline last year than he had budgeted for.
Last year's stuff
Well, I'm talking about the truck. You know, most of what the trucks do is plow.
Yeah.
Last year they didn't.
Right.
So, I mean, so when I'm saying $500 for the trucks, probably didn't spend that much for the trucks last year.
Right.
But I sit here pretty confidently and say I bet we did the year before. I think last year was kind of an anomaly.
It's two abnormal years, though. One abnormally high, other abnormally low.
I agree.
Maureen had a question. Wait a minute.
I just have a comment. What, in fact, do you do if they only give you $1,000 or whatever that number was? What happens then when you need to use $2,000 worth?
He has a whole budget, Maureen. Gasoline isn't the only thing in his budget. He'll have $122,000.
But he's questioning that right now.
He can overrun one line and undercut another line.
So something else.
He has flexibility.
I've got a question. The actual numbers through 12/31/15 was $28.52 for gasoline. Why don't we just leave that the way it is, and we'll cut it around $700.
Gentlemen, stop.
That includes gas and diesel and oil. Leave it the way it is.
Okay. All right. In favor of the motion of finalizing the cemetery budget, $122,000.
Excuse me, the motion is not that. I made the motion at what is printed in the book at $124,143. Christy suggested that that management and the Board of Selectmen concurred that that number could be reduced because of gasoline costs by $1,683. Now, the question I have in my mind is that $1,683 reduction still appropriate? Rusty, do you have a thought?
Lots changed in a month.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
A lot has changed in gas prices in a month, and I don't disagree that it's probably closer to this, and it's a crystal ball when you look at it.
Yeah.
Are you seconding, Mr.?
Are you still as comfortable with this number as you were when you voted for it at the Board of Selectmen?
Not seeing the prices now. I think we're a little under, and I'm a little worried about it, quite frankly.
But are you seconding the motion? We're not going to be here all
the
night.
The motion has already been seconded.
Who seconded?
Mr. Henderson.
Stephen did. Sorry about that. Okay.
Maybe, Rusty, what we could do is consider, at least in the cemetery, I'm not necessarily advocating this all around the board, but cemetery keeps a tight budget. And, I mean, they really are squeaky tight. And so instead of a $1,600 cut, maybe we can just do an $800 cut.
I was going to suggest that. You said both years have been an anomaly. I'll split it with you.
That's where it was, a mind meld.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay, give me a figure.
Madam Chair, I modify my motion to be
$123,543. 543. That would be the total?
Yes.
For what? For gas now?
That would be the total for
that's
the account.
That's the total for cemetery, reflecting an $800 reduction from the original Board of Selectmen.
Mr. Henderson has seconded. In favor of that adjustment, bottom line in cemeteries, 123,543.
What's the final number?
123,543.
On your total cemeteries, the very bottom line under Budget Committee. In favor? Come on, wake up. Unanimous. Bless you. Thank you, Danny, very much.
Thank you.
Mosquito control, Adam Kaiser.
Madam Chairman, before we get too carried away with this, when we went through the gas and diesel accounts before, we recognized, I think everybody at this table recognized the fact that cemeteries was cut a lot more than what the rest of the accounts were.
Yeah.
So I have no problem with what we just did whatsoever, but I think I ought to abandon that approach for the rest of the accounts.
I did specify, Mike, that I wasn't proposing this across the board, but cemeteries was particularly because they do keep a squeaky-tight budget in cemeteries.
I wasn't arguing that point.
So I'm with you on that.
I was only arguing that they had a bigger cut than other people did by the gasoline that was refigured by Christy, which we appreciate her doing.
Acknowledged, Captain.
Thank you.
Okay, mosquito control and Kaiser, Barbara. And you are showing contracted services $103,250.
And. Get a page on mosquito control.
You have a contract.
What page are we on?
Remember, I gave you the list here, and we're doing the quick accounts first.
Mosquito control. We're looking
mosquito
for the page.
Mosquito control.
Page.
Will anyone move?
About the page number before we get carried away.
What's
OBS
the page?
Mosquito control in your tabs.
OBS.
In the tabs.
What is it in the OBS?
In your tabs, mosquito control 103-250.
What's the same budget as last year?
Mr. Henderson is making a motion.
Mosquito control, Madam Chair, for? An amount yet to be determined. Let's see. It is $103,250 bucks.
Seconded by?
Seconded
by Mr. Henderson. In favor, ladies and gentlemen? Mosquito.
What is the number that's?
$103,950.
No, it's 103,250.
Wasn't I saying that?
No, you say 103,250. You don't use that.
$103,250.
Thank you very much.
Seconded by Mr. Henderson. In favor? Hello, mosquitoes.
Here we go.
There aren't any out there tonight. Brian Lapham, what are you doing?
I'm waiting for you to scratch continue the motion.
Well, the motion is on the table. Are we voting to get rid of the mosquitoes? Thank you.
Are you
David?
Okay with this number?
I believe Mr. Jones brought something up.
Oh, God love us, yes.
Just ask for the yeses.
No.
Ask for the yeses.
Well, ask for discussion first.
No for you? Well, for discussion's over.
Never started.
Discuss it, I'm not coming.
Ask for the yeses, then ask for the noes.
In favor? I'm sorry, try again. Thank you. Sonny, what are you doing? Bless you. I know you did, but we're having a little. Okay, what is Mr. Jones doing?
Hoping to get a discussion. Are you still comfortable with this number?
Yes.
Thank you. Then I'm in the affirmative. See how easy that was?
Brian, what are you?
Mary Louise, ask for the noes. Ask for the noes.
Yes. There are no votes? Abstaining? Oh, you're a no vote. Okay, everybody else is in favor. God bless us. Thank you, Ann, very much.
Each and every one.
And you're all set.
Yes,
welfare, direct assistance. Michelle?
Madam Chair, welfare total is $61,705. I so move.
Second.
Michelle Kingsley?
We are, honey.
Michelle, do you have any desire for more or less money?
Well, you've got to be careful on the more money. Because she can't.
I think it was an adequate estimation of next year. We can't be 100% certain, but
right.
It is our best
guess. I appreciate
guess.
Your work. I appreciate
Madam
you
Michelle,
being as accurate as you can. And
what?
I hope that we can move to immediate
tabs.
Vote.
Tabs. Tabs.
I want the OBS number.
18.
18, thank you.
Love us, yes.
You can say that again.
Okay. Yes. Gee, whiskers.
Any more discussion?
It's showing $21,500.
Can we repeat that motion, please?
Whoops, direct assistance, I'm sorry.
$61,705.
Yes.
Motioned by Jones, seconded by Henderson.
Mike Plouffe.
Me.
Mike.
Seconded
Plouffe.
By Mike Plouffe.
In favor of
third
Michelle's budget for 2017.
And the amount is
$61,705? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Madam Chair.
Yes, sir.
No doubt you desire to do conservation.
Conservation. Who's here?
Which
for
I move.
Oh, there she is.
Although
yes.
I do not necessarily favor.
Oh, my goodness.
Conservation for $1.130573 million. Oh, no, that's cultural and recreation, sorry.
Okay.
I move conservation for
$35,525. $35,525. Rayanne Dionne, D-I-O-N-N-E, and Barbara Reynaud, R-E-N-A-U-D, from conservation. Good evening, ladies.
Good evening.
A pleasure to see you. Okay, we're showing you at $35,525 for 2017. Anything further to say?
Not unless you guys have any questions.
You're just carrying
here
on a working
question.
All right. You understand the intent of the motion to finalize the conservation
yes,
budget?
Yes, and I have something to say on it.
Wait a minute. Have we a motion to speak to?
Yes, I moved.
You have moved.
And Mr. Pluff has seconded.
And Mr. Pluff seconded. Thank you.
Traditional Henderson 30.
Go ahead.
The Conservation Commission has a conservation fund. The conservation fund can be used for any and all activities related to their conservation activities. I see them being in the budget and having a separate fund, same purpose, to be double dipping.
The fund is land purchase.
No, it is not, Madam Chair. We went through multiple years of explaining that the conservation fund is not the land acquisition fund, it's the conservation fund. And it's stipulated in state law that can be used for any activities related to conservation activity, including but not limited to land acquisition.
We all agree.
Right. Well, at least we did until this moment, yes.
Thank you.
And so I see having two sources of revenue to fund their expenses to be inappropriate, and that's why I don't support it. It is not that I don't support your work. I think you do a fine job. Okay.
The only comment I would make is that it has a $0 amount.
Pardon?
It has a $0 amount.
Subline item for land?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I acknowledge that.
Okay.
But your conservation fund can be used for anything related to your including your salary. Can be paid under state statute. It can be paid by the conservation fund.
Conservation, I'm just clarifying that it's a $0 amount.
I acknowledge that, and I also acknowledge the fine work you do.
Thank you.
And the reason I'm not supporting this is because of the principle that I just cited.
Got it.
Okay. You understand the intent of the motion?
Fully.
Thank you. I am seeing $35,525 for Conservation Commission in 2017. Okay. In favor?
Okay, excuse me, can you say that amount again?
$35,525. Okay. Everybody on this side? Okay, Brian, what are you doing? Okay, what are you doing? Okay, try it again. Put your hands up if you're in favor. Okay, everybody on this side except Brian. Everybody over here except Jones and Maurer and Lapham. Okay. The chair is in favor. Okay. Jones, Maurer, and Lapham. Ladies,
Madam
thank
Chair,
you.
No so doubt you want to do parks and recreation. Wait, it's a total line now, is that right?
Thank you very much for what you do, and we'll see you at the public hearing. Thank you. Okay.
This is the one
okay. Parks and Rec, Diana. I think I saw her. And we're also going to do parking admin while Diana is here, and that's showing as number 19 on the list. Good evening.
What are we doing on? Parks and Rec.
$235,600.
So under the tab, it actually shows the
Parks and Recreation is a blue tab toward the end of the book, and we are seeing for Diana total Parks and Recreation right now. I have no change. Are we doing a change in gasoline on this, Christy? Because I admit I had a little mess trying to figure out the gasoline stuff that you passed out.
So am I reading correctly, the total parks and recreation is
$235,000? No, you're not.
I didn't think so.
Madam Chair? Madam Chair? When we discussed this once before, we added some money to it.
Right.
Oh, I have 18050 up on grounds and fields. Okay. Yes. So it should be 240610?
That's correct.
Yes.
All right. That looks good.
Diana, isn't this also where we were funding for lifeguards, which we also reduced?
No, the lifeguards are in a different area now.
They're a different area this year.
They're just not in this budget now.
Okay.
I want to be sure we don't miss anyone.
Yeah.
Can I have a motion for the $240,610 to get this on the table?
What was the previous adjustment before you make any motion?
What?
What was the previous adjustment?
$5,000 on grounds and fields.
Subtracting it?
We went from 13050 to 18050,
okay.
Which makes your bottom line total 240610.
Right. I'll make that motion.
Bless you.
240.
Second.
Thank you.
240.
Okay. Moved by Mr. LaBranche, seconded by Mr. Henderson.
What was the total again? 240 what?
240,610.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, now, discussion questions for Diana. We went through her accounts pretty thoroughly when she was in the last time. You comfortable with that? What? Oh, Christy's checking the gas. Okay. We had $1,619 on the original sheet.
See, the garage was $1,950.
Oh, that's cheap.
She did. She dropped.
So,
$600.
What page are you on, Ginny?
OBS 19 on the one that was handed out
Thank
tonight
you.
That we're ignoring.
Okay. We're not ignoring.
Yeah, but Ginny, we accept only the first iteration of the budget.
Yes.
We're not ignoring it, Jenny. We are incorporating it with budget committee committee.
What are we doing?
As opposed to changing the historic record reflecting the Board of Selectmen made the original suggestion as such, which they did not. That's how I understand the decision.
Have a figure, Christy?
I know, big deal. What's the difference? None.
Exactly. I was going to get it.
Wait a minute. I can't hear her because everybody's making a racket. It's like kindergarten. Stop it. Christy, I'm sorry.
Gasoline and diesel, the total together, are $1,172 if you want to adjust those lines.
Okay, so instead of 1619, you're saying 1172.
Yes,
right?
Split out, yes.
Okay, somebody who has quick math skills is going to have to give me a bottom line. We'll take 1172 off 1619, and with that we'll give us
447.
I'm sorry?
447.
447.
244.47, is that what you're saying?
Oh, I'm not adding it all. I'm just doing that one line.
The difference of 447.
Stop! Not everybody at once. What, Christy?
Susan Jones just said
that.
It's a difference of
447.
No, actually, I did, but that's okay.
Yes. Maureen, go ahead.
We all did.
You said this.
You always do, but I thought I'd throw something in.
Maureen, you said subtract $447.
I subtracted the $1,172 from the $1,619.
Okay,
and that's
so,
$447.
So
any teacher will tell you that.
$240 and what?
So
we need a bottom line.
I don't know. I mean,
subtract
240. I know the arithmetic. That's not my point.
Well, I'm looking for arithmetic right now.
All right. Well, the arithmetic is simple, Madam Chair.
No.
The Board of Selectmen had previously recommended via their handout sheet, via management, to reduce that by from 1619 to 1172,
yes.
Which, thanks to Maureen, reflects a $447 difference.
Yes, and
okay.
I want to know what difference that makes in the bottom line.
It makes a difference of $447, amazingly.
I'll subtract it.
240173.
Bless you, Ginny. Thank you.
Okay.
But that goes back to the same question. Is that
one
the right?
1-6-3.
Madam Chair, I made the original motion. I'd like to change it, please, to
$240,163.
Yes.
Okay.
And that includes two adjustments, one in
that
grounds and fields, adding $5,000. And in gasoline, subtracting $447.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Just be careful, as Mr. Jones has said in the past, the price of gas has come up an awful lot in a month.
I realize that.
Okay.
And it could tank tomorrow. I mean, who knows?
Yep, you're
all right. You understand the intent of the motion for Parks and Rec. Mr. Henderson seconded? Okay. In favor of the complete Parks and Rec budget, 240163. May I have hands? Okay, everybody on this side. Okay, Mr. Jones, you're the only person not, and the chair is in favor. Mr. Jones, what do you
think? Madam Chair, if you're in favor, then so aren't I, goddamn.
Well,
absolutely.
I think that's exciting.
About
okay,
time you
we need to do a parking admin.
Unanimous,
my dear, yes.
Parking admin would be here. Police.
Got it as number 19 on the sheet, but I don't know.
You got it at 19?
I don't know what it means.
Is that OBS 19?
No.
There it is, parking admin. It's a sort of a maroon tab.
Parking
Okay, I'm seeing 83,726.
Yes.
That matched, Diana, with what you've got?
I'll make that motion.
Mr. LaBranch is kind enough to make that motion. Have I a second? Mr. Henderson is seconding.
Diana, is this where the lifeguards are?
No, it's a different line.
Which lifeguards were in the Parks and Recreation budget. I don't know. They've been taken out of that budget.
There's somewhere else.
This has always been set.
Yeah, I just wonder whether... Oh, they're not under you anymore, is what you're saying.
I don't know.
He's going to help me, all right?
What page is this on?
This has always been separate from Parks and Rec.
Okay, safety. Quiet.
Public safety, thank you.
Christy, where is parking? Where is
public
life
safety?
Public safety.
We'll
be getting
safety.
To that later.
Okay, that's we'll do
later.
That afterwards.
I thought we were in parking, Mr.
We are.
All right. I have a bottom line here on parking admin, 83,726, moved by Mr. LaBranch, seconded by Mr. Henderson. Do you understand the intent? In
yes.
favor? Michael, what are you doing?
Okay. I'm trying to find the page in the
all
book.
All right. What are you doing, Mr. Jones?
I'm with you, Madam Chair.
Oh, wonderful. Unanimous. Music to my ears. On the lifeguards, Diana,
yep.
realistically, can you hire them?
I had a talk with, I don't know if you know Bruce Montville or not,
yeah.
but he
yeah.
and I have been, we actually met
lifeguard
last month
OBS
hoping to maybe recruit some lifeguards from
stop talking.
Some local schools. I mean, I advertised out at the University of New Hampshire and places
yeah.
like that last year, but we were going to see if we might be able to even find some local schools and you know, the high school, older high school children, see if we could get some of them to be recruited to get trained, and we could work with the Red Cross on that. So we're going to try, unless he tells me not to.
We'll try again.
I'm going to try one more year and see if I can get
some. But lifeguards are not on this motion.
No, I know that. Okay, the motion passed unanimously. Okay, Diana, thank you so much.
All right. Thank you.
Town clerk here? No. Okay. Tax collector?
Nope.
Okay, good. We're moving. Dead Tinker assessing. Good evening, Mr. Tinker. Super quick.
Why are we skipping the tax?
Not here.
Here it is.
Yellow tab.
No gas.
There you go. Okay, I'm seeing $287,501, and this has gone down because the reval is over. Mr. LaBranch has moved. Mr. Plough seconded. Okay. You understand the intent. Ed, any second thoughts, changes? Are you comfortable?
We're good.
We're good to go. Okay.
Okay. You have questions for Ed? We have a motion on the table.
Let's vote.
Questions for the assessing officer? Okay, there appearing to be none. To finalize the assessing budget at 287501, in favor?
That would mean it.
In unanimous, Barbara. Thank you, Ed,
very
much.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Planning board, I see Mr. McNamara running around there somewhere. And Jason, or Sean, the planner.
Okay.
Good evening, gentlemen. We've been scared of planning. Give me a minute.
Good evening. Before I sit down, I want to say hello.
Well, it's a pleasure to see you.
A large board. I have to take a little boy's seat. Usually when I run my meetings, we have plenty of seats, but it's a big board, and I understand that because there's a lot
to
go on.
We're too poor to afford seats.
Madam Chair,
no, don't worry.
I assume you'd like to move the total for planning. Is that correct?
Well, that is exciting. Thank you, Mr. Jones.
We're going to say hello
seconded
to everybody.
Seconded by Mr. Plough.
Okay.
I didn't make the motion yet. So we asked if you would entertain a motion.
Yes.
All right. I am going to change the number from the book to $145,169.
Why?
That's a $5,000 reduction. I'm targeting contracted services and dues. There's $5,000 in there. Because you might have grants coming down and you want some extra slush money to deal with those grants.
That's
from previous testimony.
It is
Isn't
not,
that right?
That is not slush money.
Excuse me. Fluff money, whatever you want to call it. It's fluff.
Jason explained that in detail.
And I'll address the gentleman again. So
go ahead.
So basically, that's just
$5,000 that the planning board wanted to include in there.
Yes.
Should any grant opportunities come along that require matching funds, we'd be able to pursue those opportunities. If those matching funds aren't available to us, we can't pursue those opportunities. We've been making a diligent effort in the couple of years that I've been here to pursue grants. We've received some, and we want to keep that going. That's the purpose of that.
And as I asked before, can you speak any time in town's history when we didn't have matching funds available elsewhere in the budget to pursue such grants?
I've
been here 2 years.
So in your entire time here, that's never happened?
I mean, we've had matching funds from contracted services and dues in the past. I mean, that's been used. We haven't had as much there, but the reason is because we're pursuing them more assertively. I think it's
I understand that, but my point is that there's never been budgeted for, let's just in case we happen to stumble upon a grant, a matching fund grant, let's throw some extra money in the budget. We've never had that before that I'm aware of. I'm willing to be educated as to when that may have happened. It certainly hasn't happened on my 4 years on the board here, or the committee here.
What ends up happening to us as a planning department for a town, this town, and any other town, is that on occasion, planning opportunities come available, and they require matching funds. And most of the time, not always, but most of the time, they can require us to match those funds via work. Through the planning department, myself, other members of the board, so that they offset.
So-called in-kind.
Yes, exactly. There are times where they want the matching funds to literally match. That's correct. And as the time has come on in my 6 years as being on the planning board, the funds, the dynamic of the whole idea has grown to a point where a $2,000 matching fund isn't going to work, or a $1,000 matching fund, and you can't go to the town planner, the town manager, and say, we need $1,000 to match this fund because there's no money there. Because of the dynamics of the world, and because of how planning has gone from local planning into coastal planning, into planning about worrying about FEMA and all kinds of things that could happen to us, things come up to where now there may be an opportunity to jump onto a grant where the fund might have to be $4,000 versus $2,000 from 5 years ago.
So my question then is, why can't you go to the town manager and ask for the $5,000?
We can.
Should the opportunity arise?
You won't.
Of course we can. The communication is there. The opportunities are there. But what we felt as a board is that if we plan to have a $5,000 matching fund in the event that somebody is willing to grant us money to do something for the town of Hampton that requires a matching fund and not just in kind, sometimes it's both. It could be in kind work and some funds as well. Then we wanted to be prepared to jump on that because these times are not like they were 20 years ago. Today, we're talking about today and tomorrow and next month and next year and you see it all over the news. Everything is dynamic, and oh my goodness, the world is falling in on us.
But a grant of the nature you described would be a great deal for the town. And there is ample funds in the budget to find $5,000 without assuming we're going to run into such a grant and spend the $5,000.
You're not going to find it in the
budget. That's really what it comes down to. Do we assume we're going to stumble upon a matching grant to $5,000 that's going to be great for the town, or do we assume that if we were to find it, we could find $5,000 somewhere in a $26 million budget to find $5,000?
First of all, we don't
assume. So this is really what it comes down to, right?
Sir, we don't assume anything because we can't. We're a town. We have funds that come in and funds that are expended via the town manager and the town budget committee and so on. We can't assume anything. So what we do as a planning board is we try to plan for the future. And as a planning board, we say, can we plan to have $5,000 in the hole if there is a grant? And if it's not, if there's no grant, then the money isn't spent.
I understand. You're making a prediction in the future, and somehow you are able to do that without making assumptions.
Okay,
we're a planning board, but that's the nature of the board. The board is not a board like a budget committee or a select board or any other board. It's a planning board. That's what we do. We plan for the future, and we plan and we hope to heck that it doesn't happen. But should something happen, and should there be a grant that's available to us that we can jump on, and we can match it with his work, my work, Lori's work, everyone else on the board's work, great. If we can't and we need to match some funds, then we need to have the money there without having to go to the town and say, give us some of your money.
Okay, Brendan.
Yeah, and if you don't find it, it's $5,000 that the taxpayers were taxed that they needn't have been taxed
get,
for.
No, we don't use
my question
it.
If we don't have $5,000 out, why not $10,000 under the same assumption?
Because prediction, I should say.
Mr. Jones,
why not 20?
Mr. Lapham has
that's
a question.
That's okay. Can I please answer him first?
Yeah.
If we don't find a grant, or a grant doesn't come near us that we think is going to help the town of Hampton, then we don't use it, and we don't use those matching funds. So therefore, the money is put back into the general fund, and it's not used.
Except that it has been taken out of the taxpayer's pocket.
Not for us. It's been taken out of the taxpayer for the general fund.
It's still been taken out of the taxpayer's pocket for reasons that were not necessary.
Well, what we're trying
I
to
want
do
a budget for items that are necessary to run the town properly.
I
not for,
that.
Hey, just in case kind of stuff.
The money's already been taken out of the taxpayer's pocket. It is now in the general fund.
It doesn't need to be in the budget.
It's already in the budget.
It's already been taken.
Brian,
it doesn't need to be in the budget to be taken
hold
again.
Hold on for a minute.
Yes.
Mr. Lapham has a question.
Do you already have a fund established?
Not
for. Are you going to have to create one? No, for the $5,000.
It's under the contracted services and dues. That's what the board had discussed, putting that item. We've, like I said, we've had matching funds
we've
from that
used
in the past,
it in the past. Yes.
For that purpose. That's the same fund that we pay the Rockingham Planning Commission.
Is there currently any money in that fund now?
There is no fund, Brian. It's a line item.
Or line item.
Yes, line item. Right. Certainly line item.
Sub-line item.
We do use it.
Right, yeah, there was a few thousand dollars in there, and it's been used this year. And it is basically used
now.
It was basically used in full in 2016. So the point is, with the additional number of grants we're pursuing, the deadlines on those grants tend to be tight sometimes, where we don't the money's readily available. Should we have need for matching funds, if there's a staff match, then we use that too.
And you have to understand, grants don't come along and say, "Hey, take your time, figure it out." They
you
say,
"Brendan, they should."
Well, I agree with you. They
Mr.
should, but
Pierce
they,
has a quick question.
Sorry, Mr. Pierce.
I want to make a statement. If you have a grant that comes along and you need $5,000, like Mr. Jones said, there's probably $5,000 in a $26 million budget, and all you have to do is have the selectmen okay it. It's that simple. And now, whether you want to go along with that or not, let's move it to a vote.
Okay. Wait a minute. Can I make a point?
Yes,
point
please.
Mr. Jones made a motion.
Yes.
Nobody seconded it with his
I
number.
Thought.
No. It was
Mr.
not
Pierce
seconded.
Did.
No. Oh, you did
Pierce
second it?
Did.
Okay.
Barbara, you have that?
I don't have the second.
Right. That's what I'm saying. It wasn't seconded.
Mr. Pierce said that he...
So you're saying there's no motion on the table?
No. I'm saying
Mr.
it wasn't
Pierce
seconded. So now you're going to second.
Why don't you make it again, then?
That's what I was going to do.
Yeah, what is the motion?
No motion. The motion is to approve $145,169 for the planning board. $145,169.
So your intent is to remove the grant, remove the $5,000 from...
Yeah, there's a line called contracted services
and
debt, which the Board of Selectmen approved for $21,640.
Okay.
I want to reduce that by $5,000.
All right. You understand the intent of the motion. In favor of Mr. Jones' motion. What, my dear?
Wait a minute. The $145,169, is that the figure Mr. Jones
yes.
said
that
is less?
That is a subtotal.
That's the less?
That is it.
Yeah.
Right. That's a subtotal for planning board.
Yes.
Okay, in favor of the motion made by Mr. Jones. Okay, Pierce, Lapham, and Jones. Opposed? Everyone else. Okay, now, back to the main motion as proposed, $150,169.
I would like to make
Mr.
that
LaBranche
motion.
Mr. LaBranche is so moving.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Henderson. You understand that, I'm sure.
Yes.
In favor of the motion by Mr. LaBranche, seconded by Mr. Henderson, to have the total number of the total amount of money showing in the planning board budget. Okay.
Could you give me that?
150,169.
And Mr. Lapham, Mr. Pierce, and Mr. Jones were opposed. Thank you so much, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
We appreciate what you do.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you. By the way, I believe the planning board does a hell of a lot of work.
Thank
and
you.
And I appreciate it. I really do.
And I think that this board is overwhelming, but it's a good board.
Anybody here from zoning? Because I can't see through the chair. Nobody from zoning. And everybody was notified. We'll pick this up Thursday. In library, I don't see Amanda.
You don't need them to make
okay,
the motion,
Chief?
Madam Chair.
Yeah.
We're going to do the
8 o'clock, right on the dot.
Oh, boy, are we good.
Madam
good
Chair.
Evening, sir.
Good evening, and Happy New Year.
Fire, Happy New Year to you as well. Reviewing the Chief's budget. This is a pretty clean cut budget
where's
that we reviewed on the... We reviewed it before the 20th. There's fire, a yellow tab. I have one quick question for you, Chief, before we... I've had questions from a couple of individuals who are residents of Hampton who have had ambulance billing. They've had runs where you billed an EMS, but their insurance wasn't enough apparently to cover the billings. Are we still forgiving that?
Well, that depends on individual circumstances.
Okay.
There are certainly means to do that. They actually can put in a claim to have that forgiven, and that's done at the Board of Selectmen.
But it would be a personal request
to
the Board of Selectmen.
It goes through finance, right? Through the finance.
Through finance.
Right.
Okay. Thank you for that. Yes, sir.
What is the charge for the ambulance service, sir?
Ooh, off the top of my head, I do believe that BLS services are $544. I'm not sure on ALS service. I believe they're $1,079.
You go to somebody's house, take them to the hospital, it's $500. Am I understanding?
You don't understand that if they have to administer oxygen or any kind of drugs, any of that stuff, it's all kept track of.
Right.
So there's a base price and then all the add-ons.
It's not
That's
just right. the transport. It's the services accompanying the
That's
transport.
That's true.
Like a minimum.
Right.
And what we do now is a package bill. Historically, there was almost an a la carte. So if they gave oxygen, if they used the nasal cannula versus a mask, or if mm-hmm. they gave an IV, each of those charges had to be picked. Now it's combined billing. So if it's a BLS call and the ALS services, such as medicines are not administered or cardiac monitor is not used, then it's one rate charge. If those services are incorporated, then it's a second rate charge.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Does
Medicare pay for all?
And those charges are correct.
Thank you, sir.
Maureen?
I have a question, Chief.
Yes,
under what circumstances would the services be forgiven?
That's out of my office. When that happens, they request a waiver of funds. We've had several in the last couple of months where their balance, what they've done, has gone into a payment plan, which the town has been working out with them separately. So I couldn't give you, for instance, as everybody's got a different circumstance.
Okay. Wait one second.
I was asking a question, Madam
Chairman. I know.
He was answering, if you don't mind.
Okay,
thank
I'm
you.
Sorry. Go ahead.
Does Medicare cover the ambulance?
Medicare actually, they have a fixed rate billing, and theirs is typically the lowest. What they do is they will pay a certain proportion of the bill. Balance billing on Medicare billing is not allowed. So that portion is responsible by secondary insurances and whatever else might be out there.
Thank you.
Okay, Sonny?
Yeah. On the EMT, how do you determine which hospital you go to? Suppose somebody wants to.
Sure, that's a great question. A lot of times it's patient preference. If they want to go to the Exeter, then we take them to the Exeter. If they want to go to Anna Jakes, we take them to Anna Jakes, Portsmouth. Additionally, we also are paying attention to what the conditions are of the patient, and there are certain capabilities of hospitals. The Portsmouth Regional right now is a level 2 trauma center, and they're able to accept much sicker patients than Anna Jakes or Exeter Hospital. So if there's a really sick patient and they say, oh, I don't know, you take me wherever you want, well, we're going to determine where they go based on that.
Some of the hospitals are coordinating with MGH at this point.
Sure, the tertiary hospitals down in Boston, or whether they get flown to Dartmouth.
In Dover.
Yep.
Will.
Yeah. Good.
Yep, that's on the hospital to decide. Our providers will decide on scene where they're going to go, and from there they make that decision and fly them out. The only other thing, and I say fly them out, we actually do that as well. We'll call DART or we'll call MedFlight, and they'll come to the scene for us, or we'll go up to the hospital to do that. And then that's on the helicopter personnel to determine where they go from there.
That's a good question. Mr. LaBranche is prepared to make a motion for the fire department.
But before I make that motion, I need to ask Christy a question, okay? Because in the book we have $3,549,446, yet the new number is $3,545,545. Christy, does that reflect the changes in only gasoline?
The 3545545 on OBS 12
yes.
reflects only changes in gasoline
and diesel. Yeah. Okay, so that would be the number that I am going to.
3545 what?
$3,545,545.
Oh, wow. Okay. Mr. LaBranche is moving. Seconded by Mr. Henderson. Okay. I have a couple of quick questions in here. We did a pretty thorough review. ICE rescue.
This is the end
of material.
Yes, ma'am. We at the end of November, there was a tremendous end of the year deal that the town manager was very hot on. He wanted to make sure that we did what was appropriate, and at your urging as well. We were able to secure ice rescue equipment, to wit, a sled, a reel, and some other flotation devices. So we were able to purchase that, and now that's at our price.
So you're all set with that out of the
minus training
budget?
Well, we still haven't performed any of the training yet. We got in the equipment, no. I believe, a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago.
You have the equipment that you need now.
Now we need to get out on the ice and train. Right.
Okay. And your hose?
Well, what we did, and I do believe when I was here in front of you for the Warren article, I mentioned that Engine 1 and Engine 3 have been outfit with hand lines. So on the fire truck, you see a lot of hoses. And hand lines are the inch and three-quarter lines that we take off first to go fight a residential fire. We have larger lines, 2.5-inch lines, which are more for commercial structure or larger fire. It could be a residential, but a larger fire. And also supply lines, which is 5-inch lines, 3-inch lines. We purchased only inch and three-quarter lines, and we did that for 2 fire engines. As you know, Engine 2 is out of service right now, so we didn't outfit that one.
But those 35-year-old or...
Yeah, they're going by the wayside, lines, thankfully.
Are you...
They're going to be taken care of and shipped off. Any of the older hoses, like I told you, we had some that were in the 14, 15-year range. They're going to be put into the reserve, as you will. They're tested, so we're very confident in their ability to do the job, but they're going to take the place of the 35-year-old hose.
I just don't want you out there with old hoses.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
All right. Any other questions for the chief?
One follow-up question.
Sure.
In the future, yes. Can we make that part of a policy when we buy a new engine?
Sure. So as you're aware, we bought Engine 4, right? And in doing so, the Warren article was very specific, and it stated to purchase an engine pumper for the town of Hampton, not to purchase and equip. So that's, you know, my error as a new fire chief too, is to make sure that moving forward that we do that appropriately with the Warren article and funds to cover it. Putting that money in there so that we can actually equip it with new equipment is going to be
there. Yeah, that's something specific. You can discuss it, deliver or whatever.
Correct.
Yes, we need hoses when we order.
Sure. And you know, for what it's worth, we got one heck of an engine there, and I know you've seen it. It's a beautiful engine. It does a tremendous job. The guys really like it. It's not cheap. Fire engines are not cheap, and they continue to go up. We've seen with the company that we use to purchase it, we know that we've gotten 3% price increases in the last 18 months. So they're continuing to rise. Those costs are rising. So to make sure that we do that appropriately, I'll certainly be more vigilant.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. You have a question?
For some time, yes.
Hi, Chief.
Oh, sir. Great.
Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year.
As you recall, we had a lovely discussion on new equipment.
We did.
And I wanted to make a motion, but wasn't allowed to make a motion, so I guess I'm going to have to do that tonight.
Okay.
But just to refresh everyone, you had requested for new equipment $48,950. The town manager reduced that to $22,950. That number was blessed by the Board of Selectmen.
Correct.
Okay? And I asked you, well, what are you going to buy, and what can't you buy that you planned on buying, and you were not sure what you were going to buy.
Correct.
And that the descriptive sheets behind the numbers were no longer appropriate, because the numbers had changed so radically. So the open question was, what are you going to buy with the remaining $22,950?
My goal with that line item this year moving forward is hydraulic rescue equipment. We call them jaws of life. You've heard of them, jaws of life. The older version that we have right now that we're taking off of engine 2 to use is a generator and reel system. We're looking to go to battery off. As you might imagine, that's the way of the world right now. They're much lighter, they're much safer, and they're also able to be used in places that you don't have to carry the generator and all the hoses to go with. So
you're looking to buy a Jones Electric?
Yeah, well, cutter, spreader, battery charger, and four batteries will cost a total of $24,000. I priced that out today.
$24,000?
Right. Close enough.
So you actually need another $1,050.
I feel very comfortable that we'll be able to do that. I priced it out myself. I know that I have a Captain McMahon who's in charge of hand tools, and I'm sure that he could do a little better job.
Well, if you need $24,000, just say so. We'll make it $24,000. I mean, I want the budget to be accurate. I'm not just looking to cut.
Me too.
I'm looking to make it accurate.
And I understand that. I feel very comfortable that I'll be able to purchase what I need.
All right. Wait a minute.
Further
Wait
questions?
A minute. Yes. As you know, we discussed the fireworks.
We did.
Detail display as well.
Last one of the year.
Last year, just to remind the audience what it was about. Last year, we budgeted zero and spent $7,500.
We did. You want to talk on that, Mr. Jones?
But that was actually paid out of the so-called Fund 26, I think.
That's correct. Right?
Now, Fund 26, I did some research on, and this is going to be coming up in other budgets, fire and not just fire, but police and DPW as well. This was actually passed in 2006 under warrant article number 21, and its purpose is the funds to be expended from this revolving fund to cost of police and fire department private details.
Correct.
So when you spent money for the fireworks from this fund, you were properly using this fund. That's just a simple fact. As far as
yep. I agree.
Absolutely correct thing to do. But since we have a fund for that purpose, in my mind, it doesn't make sense to have a line in the budget for that purpose as well. So I really do oppose having two sources to fund the same activity when one is more than sufficient, has proven to be more than sufficient.
Sure. Well,
and there's no reason to believe it won't be sufficient next year.
And I appreciate what you're saying. However, with the Fund 26, that is a revolving account, which means that they have input. The fireworks details, from the perspective of the fire department, does not generate input. Right. We don't have Verizon coming in. We don't have Unitil coming in and paying to have that fund created and added to. When we were drawing down, that was a stopgap for that. Okay. Yes, sir.
You're doing these fireworks, the details for the village district.
That's correct.
Whether the village district is paying for that detail or not is not relevant to the expense we're discussing. Okay. And what we're discussing is the expense of the detail. In the fund's purpose, it says right here, these funds may be expended only to fund the cost of police and fire department private detail. Highly appropriate to use the fund, therefore not appropriate to be in the budget, in my mind.
And I understand your point. However, I would say that it's a finite fund, not never-ending.
The taxpayers' pockets are finite as well.
And I understand that completely. The Board of Selectmen, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Bartle's here to talk about it. We did this, that can probably back me up. We did discuss that at the Board of Selectmen level, and they chose to take it on as a department because, and forgive me, Ms. Buckley, but we were talking about that through and with Mr. Rage, that this was part of the town, and so it was going to fall under the town's budget.
I'm not challenging the expense. I'm challenging how it's being financed.
I understand.
And we have a fund to finance this expense. We ought to use the fund for financing this expense. If management and the governing body decide that this is a good expense to fund, then they should be funding it from the proper source. And in my mind, that proper source is the fund that was set up to pay for private details. So-called Fund 26, which is actually called something a little bit different than that, of course, in the warrant article, the Hampton Police, Hampton Private Hager? Detail Revolving Fund, also called 26.
Well, the thing is, with this was a stop gap measure, too. But historically, it's always come out of this budget. It's always been in there. If you look back through years and years and years, we paid for the fireworks details. Usually with Fund 26, that is for... Typically, not always, but could be a cruiser detail, could be a club detail, could be a welding detail.
Correct.
Where they have a welder, where they have to have a firefighter stand by. And so the money goes into that, and then it's paid out of that fund for that. That fund raises money, and typically the town makes additional funds when they need a cruiser or they need other apparatus or stuff, so they charge for that. And that's why that fund has a little extra money in it that it doesn't always However, that fund typically was not used for the fireworks detail. It's used more for welding details as far as the fire department's concerned.
Fire watch.
Fire marshal.
Fire watches.
Fire watcher, if you have a fire watch at a house, correct.
So you're talking about reimbursable services.
Correct.
Correct.
Which well, the fireworks not, have the been determined
on. And the warrant article doesn't say for reimbursable expenses. It says funds may be expended only to fund the costs of police and fire department private details. It doesn't say where those private details generated revenue for the fund. It doesn't say that.
So then make a motion however you want. We'll see how it goes.
I just want to be clear on what we're talking about here. Last year, we budgeted zero in the budget for this, yet it was paid for out of the fund. I think that was an appropriate action to do. If the governing body decided that that was a valid expense to pay, that was an appropriate source for money to pay it. We don't need it in the budget. That's the centrality of the argument. We don't need to, I mean, if you want to, if others want to argue that, you know, we're going to make this fund be a little bit different than the wording in 2006 warrant article, that's another thing entirely, right? But I'm relying entirely on the wording in that warrant article.
Okay, Madam Fred?
Madam Chairman, this money's in there because the precinct is not a private party. They're a governmental agency. Huh. And therefore, the appropriation is made to pay for them because it can't come out of Fund 26 by its own definition.
Well, it came out last year.
Well, it shouldn't. That's why it's in here.
Well, according to this warrant article, money in this fund can only be expended by the town manager. Not even town meeting can expend money from this, according to this warrant article.
We put the money in because they're not a private entity, because we were asked to fund
it. I don't object to the funding at all. If the governing body and management decide that funding the fireworks detail for the village district fireworks is a good thing to do, that's not from my purview as a budget committee member to discuss. What it is the source of how we pay for it. We have a fund to pay for it. In fact, we have, in most recent year, paid for it via that fund. And so it seems impossible to me that anyone could argue that it's not appropriate to use the fund next year without arguing that it was inappropriately used this year.
Selectman opted to use it last year. I'm telling you what the fund says and what the town voted. It says you can't do that. You have to appropriate funds for it because the precinct is a government, not a private agency. So therefore, it requires an appropriation under the law and under the warrant article.
You can
remove it if you want. What's going to happen is that money will be taken from another line item in the fire department.
Well, I mean, that's not a decision for the budget committee, because once we give you a budget,
you
guys can do whatever you want with that budget.
Okay.
We all know
Mr. Kravitz has a question.
This discussion really belongs for the deliberative session. My question is, you've got a gasoline and a diesel line that has to be adjusted.
It has been, Sunny.
Sunny, this is a deliberative session.
We adjusted it on the bottom total.
That's why we're deliberating, Sunny.
$3,545,545. Okay, further questions for the chief? Anything further, sir, that you want to call to our attention?
So we've got $7,500 in here. I would move to amend the present motion by reducing that by $7,500 and encouraging management to use the Hampton Private Detail Fund to pay for this if they desire to pay for it.
Is there a second to
sure,
Mr. Jones?
Second for discussion.
Seconded by Mr. Pierce. You understand the intent in favor of the motion as amended? That would be
reducing by $7,500.
Reducing by $7,500. Mr. Maher, Mr. Jones, Mr. Pierce, opposed to that amended motion? Bridle, Russell, Kravitz, Lapham, Henderson, Woolsey, Plouffe, Augustine, LaBranch, and Buckley. Thank you very much for what
you do. Wait a minute.
So you got to the bottom line.
On
thank
my
you.
Motion.
Well, we do get a little carried away. At the bottom line,
we wouldn't want it.
Five, four, five. That will be confirming the complete fire department
correct.
Budget for 2017.
Right.
In favor, seconded by Mr. Henderson. Who moved that? Stephen, okay.
This reflects the reduction in gas that was
proposed before
the recent gas price increases at the pump, right?
Yes. Right. Okay, in favor of the motion?
Rusty, on that?
I don't have a crystal ball. I have to just go over.
Okay, in favor of the motion because the amendment failed. So we're going for the bottom line, $3,545,545 for the Hampton Fire Department. Okay, Bridle, Russell, Kravitz, Lapham, Henderson, Woolsey, Plouffe, Augustine, LaBranche, and Buckley. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a wonderful evening.
Now, yes, my dear?
Noes?
Ask for noes, Mara Louise.
Well, opposed, Mara Jones and
Jones.
Excuse me. I did not raise my hand.
Oh, okay. Abstention. We're just getting a little...
Ask for abstention.
There you go.
Okay, good. Thank you.
What is
one abstention. One abstention and two noes.
Yes. Now, Jones is abstaining.
Are you abstaining instead of...
No, I'm waiting for someone to call for a vote on abstention.
Okay. If we were moving along here, we might...
We wouldn't have this discussion. It would already be done.
Okay.
Dear God.
One abstain. Jones abstain.
Is there anyone opposed?
Yes.
Yes. Lapham and Maurer.
Yes. We oppose.
And Jones is abstaining.
Jones abstaining.
Okay. Thank you very much, Chief.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Have a great night.
Thank you, Chief.
All right, have a good night.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Okay. I have a special money article we're going to have to go over as well, but we need to go. We're going to go through. I didn't expect representatives here. Animal control.
Animal control. Where the hell is that?
And then we're going to go to the end of the warrant that you've
that's in the
on.
Police.
Here it is. Yes. Tab.
In the police.
You understand. Well, it's in its own separate section under Health and Human Services.
We have gas in here, no doubt, right?
Yeah.
Got a reduction for that, Christy? Yeah.
The total was 63,693. What is our reduction?
$58,127. Gasoline is dropped to
$1,923. Madam Chair, I move animal control for $58,127.
$58,127.
Yes, ma'am.
That means the adjustment in gasoline.
Can I get a second, Danielle?
Only. Danielle seconded. Bless you.
Danielle seconded.
What was the adjusted amount, Mr. Jones? Thank you.
$58,127. Reduction being from the gasoline of $1,942.
Gasoline was adjusted to
$1,900.
Oh,
correct.
Was it before?
Yes. Adjusted to from?
$7,507.09. Okay, you understand
well, that's quite a cut.
What's the new
yes,
one?
That's why we were crying about gasoline. You understand the intent of the motion for a bottom line animal control, $58,000.
Madam Chairman?
Yes.
The second, please.
Danielle Augustine.
Danielle, yes.
Madam Chair, I'm a little concerned with how we managed to reduce this gasoline by, I mean, it seems like a really dramatic number.
Mm.
Oh, Christy feels very dramatic this week, right?
No, I just based it. I based it all on what the year he said through November 25th.
Yeah.
Prorated it out and then put the new gas price per gallon. Yeah. They do have a new vehicle down there, so maybe it's getting that.
Right. Better mileage.
And if you look at
he's not using diesel.
Kind of September actuals is at $1,012.
Yeah.
At the end of September.
So
last year it was at $3,000 though.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I'm just observing that we've got
a newer vehicle too.
We've got a $7,500 subline item here, and as a result of further analysis on the gasoline, in part inspired by the Budget Committee, we have seen a $6,000 reduction.
I'll let you know what they were at the end of November if you give me a second.
I'm sorry, I'm not disputing your number. I'm just wanting to highlight what's taking place here. And give Rusty a chance to say, hey, maybe that's just too much. I mean, I'd like it to be accurate, and I assume Chrissy's number's accurate. But
In the November, their gasoline line was at $1,477.
Yeah. And the new truck is much more efficient than that old, terrible rattle trap that was driving
around.
Yeah,
for sure.
You understand the intent of the motion to confirm the animal control budget. Bottom line, $58,127. In favor?
That's the old number.
Yeah, the new
in favor? What are we doing?
I was trying to get the correct number for the gasoline.
Correct number for gasoline now.
1943.
Okay. And the 58127 is correct?
Yes.
58127.
OBS 18, Mike.
No, it's 19 in the old.
OBS 18.
In favor, we're not going to be here all evening, folks.
Unanimous.
Thank you. Bless you. Okay. All right, our next is patriotic purposes. That's at the end of the budget. Patriotic and flower gardens. 500, whoops, total patriotic purposes.
Madam Chair, I move patriotic purposes for 2350 bucks.
2350, I'll second.
Seconded by Mr. Pluck.
Okay, Mr. Pluck, seconded.
In favor? Patriotic purposes? Unanimous.
Madam Chair, I'll move flowers and gardens for 500.
Excellent. And Mr. Bridle is seconding Mr. LaBranch. $500 for flower gardens. In favor?
I have a motion.
You have a motion? Okay, go ahead.
To reduce it by $500. I just cannot see.
Brian, they do a good job.
Oh, that's nice. For $500?
Is anyone?
I will second his motion so I have an opportunity to hear his statement.
To plant flowers and what have you, we already have someone doing it.
You have the flowers in front of the town office.
Right, you have the flowers. I'm sure they can pick up something reduced or whatever, but for $500, just to plant flowers throughout the town, I go back to the other thing. This is an extra.
Okay.
Any second for his motion?
Who seconded it?
I made the original motion for $500. Right. Mr. Bridle seconded it. He wants to make an amendment. Okay.
Is anyone seconding?
Tim seconded it.
I seconded it.
Discussion.
Who seconded
it? Now we're having discussion.
Yep.
Well, does that $500 reflect any cost in labor, Fred? Or is it just like for seeds and stuff?
Yeah.
No, it's just for materials.
Okay.
Yes.
Madam Chair.
Does that make a difference to you, Brian?
Nope.
At the Village District, we spend $6,000 a year for flowers and beautification, and it's plants, it's fertilizer, it's wheel carts and hoes and rakes. Mm-hmm. It's all of that. We spend $6,000 a year.
You also have orreries.
That's fine.
You also have orreries, five orreries that you
have. Yeah, so does the town.
It's more than
the
that.
Town has,
yeah. It's more than
the
that.
Town has
also
multiple.
Several thousand dollars in grants.
Right. So. All right, let's vote.
Okay, you understand the intent of the amendment that has been proposed to remove the
$500. Brian, I'm going to withdraw my second.
Okay,
that's
my second.
You don't have to do anything. No more amendment. It's gone. There's no second.
Mr. Maurer is seconding Mr. Lapham's amendment.
Oh, thank you, Dave.
In favor of the amendment?
Of the amendment.
Mr. Maurer, Mr. Lapham? Opposed? Bridle, Russell, Pierce, Kravitz, Henderson, Woolsey, Pluff, Augustine, LaBranch, and Buckley. Bless you. Now, the main motion.
Madam Chair, ask for abstentions, please.
Are we doing abstentions again? Good grief.
Yeah, imagine that's one of the options that we have. It's shocking, isn't it?
I know, Mr. Jones, I know.
Opposed and
abstentions. Some of us have a little problem with voting.
Okay,
on
so
this.
Should we please ask for the vote now for
yes.
My motion?
Yes.
Mr. The main motion, for
main motion of $500 on flower gardens in favor. Bridle, Russell, Pierce, Kravitz, Henderson, Woolsey, Pluff, Augustine, LaBranch, and Buckley. Opposed? Lapham and Maurer and...
I'm with you, Madam Chair.
You voted for it?
Oh,
yes.
My.
You just see my hand.
That's revolutionary.
We have zero.
Okay. Budget committee. Up in the front, budget committee.
Never heard of that
before. Oh, geez,
before.
So I haven't kept that. Madam Chairman, may I clarify something?
Yes, my dear.
Mr. Welch, you stated that we have $7,500 in grants for flowers.
No, I said we receive a few thousand dollars in grants. I didn't give a figure.
He's at several thousand.
Oh, okay. Because that's not the case. Okay. I'm just clarifying that because it's paid for by us.
No, none of that can get to the village district. That's probably
okay, OBS 1, Budget Committee. Secretarial wages, $2,500. Legal expenses, $2,000. Staff development, $300. The plaza expenses, $350. A total requested of $5,150. Which is the same as 2016.
What are you on right now?
Budget committee.
Oh. OBS 1.
Okay, very nice.
There's no gasoline. Down a little bit so we can hear
no gasoline.
In favor of sugar.
We donate our gasoline, don't we?
That's all. Budget committee's budget, which is the same as.
We're working on it, Madam Chair. We're just having
some
fun getting there.
In favor?
No, we have to have a motion.
Can we talk about it?
Mr. LaBranch is about to make a motion.
I make the motion to move that.
Thank you.
Second. What's that number, Mr. LaBranch?
I have no
idea. Who seconded?
I can't find it.
Everybody.
5150.
The same as 2016.
Perfect.
Nobody got wild and increased
anything. Who's the second, please?
In favor?
Everybody.
Wait a minute.
No, second.
Mr. Plouffe was.
Mr. Plouffe seconded. Okay. In favor, Madam Chair. Go ahead.
Yeah, we're unanimous.
You have to take the vote, Mr. Jones.
I'm sorry, your hand go up already.
You want to take the vote?
In favor of approving the budget committee's budget.
You were in charge.
Bridle, Russell, Pierce, Kravitz, Lapham, Henderson, Woolsey, Plouffe, Augustine, Jones. Mr. Maurer, no?
My hand was up.
Oh, your hand was up. And Maurer and LaBranch and Buckley. Unanimous. Okay, next is government buildings.
Go ahead, Stephen, do it.
That's
you take it easy there, government
buildings. It's government buildings.
I haven't found it.
Let's see.
A building in code? No.
Government buildings is a green tab just before the cemeteries.
There it is.
And I got
it. Madam Chair, I'd like to move $98,882.
Right. There's no gasoline here. The heating fuel is natural gas. And you have
seconded by Mr. Henderson.
This is $98,882. We have Mr. LaBranch making the motion. Who seconded?
Seconded by Mr.
Henderson.
Bless
you.
What was the total on the motion again?
98,882.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, in favor of the government buildings, finalizing that amount for the budget.
Oh, yes, I see it now. Okay, here it is.
What are you doing, Mr.
Jones? Yay.
Unanimous, Barbara. Thank you. We have next municipal insurance. And that is a purple tab. Just two tab. Okay.
Madam Chair, municipal insurance includes NHMA dues. You know that?
I'm sorry, I'm wrong.
Madam Chair, I'll move $3,838,501.
Seconded by?
What was the number again?
$3,838,501.
Thank you.
Liability and general insurance, health insurance, life insurance, unemployment, workers' comp, and New Hampshire Municipal Association dues.
Who is the second, please?
Mr. Maurer, seconded.
Mr. Maurer, seconded.
Do you understand the intent?
Yes.
All right. In favor?
I have discussion, please.
Oh, why? There was a little gap there. Okay, discussion.
Madam Chair, among the line items in this municipal insurance general line item is NHMA dues. The Budget Committee has enjoyed access to NHMA's legal services, as well as their coming in and doing a seminar for the Budget Committee, which has proven helpful, though some people may not agree that it's proven helpful. I believe most people think it has. I certainly do. Common education is always helpful. However, I'm a little concerned, as what I've been hearing recently, is that our access to NHMA has been cut off. And so my motivation on this NHMA dues line item is being somewhat deteriorated as a result of that cut off. The cut off I'm referring to, Jenny, is I have not confirmed it, but I have been told that the Board of Selectmen
made a motion in one of their non-camera meetings to not allow, or I should say, to allow certain people only to contact an HMA and ask them questions. Those people slash entities did not include the planning board, did not include the zoning board of adjustment, did not include the budget committee, et cetera. As I said, I didn't read the motion itself, but I understand it to be true. And so I'm concerned about the NHMA being not as advantageous to the town as it has been. And I'd be delighted if Rusty could talk to us a little bit about that as these questions wrap.
Trying to remember back as best I can. If you had asked me beforehand, I could have probably made sure I had a better answer for you.
It was December 5th, Rusty.
But I think anytime anybody's had any questions, that, you know, we've allowed them to go to the NHMA. So
what you did with your vote, because that was not, those are not sealed minutes.
Yep.
What you did with your vote was cut off everyone lower on the list except for the manager, assistant manager, town council, tax collector, and town clerk. It doesn't stipulate what entities were on the list under those four particular positions. But you stated at that meeting that other chairman, et cetera, would have to go before the Board of Selectmen.
Correct. It wasn't that we weren't going to let you do it. It's that it had to go before.
It would have to be a request.
It would have to go through the request, correct.
Of the to the Board of Selectmen.
Correct. Not that we wouldn't let you do it, just it had to come through as a request.
Now, I will share one comment with you regarding this. I took over as chairman of the Budget Committee in September when Mr. Nick Bridle resigned because of his new job. And in, end of October, early November, I had a question, so I called and reached Attorney Buckley at the NHMA. And, of course, having served on the Board of Selectmen, I had his phone number, so I called. And I don't even think I remember what the question was, but I called, and he was exceptionally rude. And after that, he said, oh, well, how did you get through? And what, you're supposed to be in line. You're supposed to hang up and go and get in the queue because you're interfering with other people who have already phoned in and are trying to get questions answered. So I said, well, this is very nice. So I hung up. And then I heard from an individual that town council had notified the New Hampshire Municipal Association when Nick Bridle took over as chairman of the Budget Committee in March. And so I said, oh, well, then I'm missing something here. I should have stopped by to see town council. So I stuck my head in Mark's office one time when I was in the town office in early November. And I said, by the way, Mark, I understand that you notified the Municipal Association when Nick Bridle took over as chairman so he could call in. And would you be kind enough to notify them, because it probably slipped through the cracks, that I assumed the chair in September? I never got a response. I never heard anything. I was never notified. As I left, I didn't stand there and berate Mark. I just asked him if he'd please do the same thing that he did for Mr. Bridle when he took the chair. And as I was walking away from his office, his secretary is right next door, and I said, Ann, you know, when you get the memo or whatever it is, would you just call me and tell me, and I'll just pick it up? And I got no response. So the Municipal Association is not on my good list, but that's all right. Now, we've beaten that to death.
But after you make that point, subsequent to that, as I understand it, the Board of Selectmen made another motion. Previously, you made a motion that said only chairman can contact NHMA without saying, may I please, to the Board of Selectmen.
Mm-hmm.
And after this point,
December 5th.
The new motion was
cut everybody off the list.
Cut off the chairman. Five. Everyone except for town five. Treasurer, town clerk, and
town manager, assistant manager.
Individuals. Whatever. Everyone but those individuals named have to go do may I please to the Board of Selectmen.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I said cut off, that's what I meant. We felt cut off.
Okay. All right.
So does that not also suggest, because it kind of does to me, that the one free seminar the town is entitled to, forgive my throat if you will, the one free seminar the town's quoted to is entitled to because of NHMA's policy, when you pay the enormous dues that we do pay, that the town gets one free seminar a year. We discovered that a few years ago, and we asked for the budget committee to use it because we wanted to have a common education for the whole budget committee, have it on TV so everyone in the town could have an education as well, because we value having a common education. So with this recent action, it kind of suggests very strongly in my mind that we may not have access to that NHMA seminar next year, which is pretty disturbing because it was like a very important thing.
I don't believe that's so. I mean, just, all you have to do is ask and we can make sure it's done.
Well, we did. We asked, the budget committee asked in late November for Regina to get a sense from the Board of Selectmen on whether they'd be inclined to do that. She said she would and report back at the next meeting. She has not done so yet.
Well, I'm not Regina. I'm not.
I understand.
Yet. I don't know what
saying. I'm just saying. This is another indication that maybe we're being cut off, but we don't want to be told yet.
I would say ask Regina, because if you ask her a question, I'm sure she'll
bring it back to you. It's in the minutes, actually.
Okay.
Oh. So, I mean, I'm just saying the fact that we're not getting a response is just another indication that maybe we're kind of like being cut off from access.
Okay. Mr. Kravitz has a question.
I've got one comment. The budget committee has new people coming on periodically. It takes few years to know what happens in the town. They only learn by asking the department heads questions while they're here. So having a budget committee submitting questions beforehand is fine, but any member of the committee is going to ask the department heads whatever they want to ask. They're residents and they have a voice.
It's not on the municipal insurance line that we're discussing, Sonny.
Okay.
So my issue is that I'm inclined to maybe think about cutting this out, and I'll say the reason why. 3 years ago, David Lang made a motion, you may recall, at the deliberative session to cut out the NHMA dues. And the deliberative session approved that, but the voters did not approve the budget, so it ended up to be a default budget.
Right.
So that cut didn't count. But one of the things that occurred was that the budget committee encouraged the executive director of NHMA to come before the budget committee and explain who exactly they were and what they're about, so that we could have an understanding going forward to the, and we got a good education out of that. You were there, Mike, right? It was very enlightening, and we didn't realize, for example, that the town was entitled to a free seminar. Apparently, we had been entitled to that for many years and never been used. And so we learned a lot from that. And there were some pros and cons in my mind about NHMA, as there would be any organization. No organization is perfect, right? No person is. And so we learned some of the good stuff and not so good stuff. And on balance, I thought, and others in the committee agreed, that we should probably continue to fund it because there's a net value added to the entire town. Independent of the fact that they themselves admitted, they are, in fact, at central purpose, a lobbying group at the State House that lobbies for the Board of Selectmen. That was what they said. Okay? Now, they do other stuff that is very useful to the town, and oftentimes their lobbying efforts on behalf of the Board of Selectmen are actually in concert, are well aligned with the Budget Committee's interests and other elements of the town's interests as well. Sometimes they're not, most of the times they are. So on balance, I saw a net advantage. But when I see us not having access, as we have for years, call up the NHMA attorney. I don't think we've ever abused it. I don't think I personally called him once. All right. But knowing he was there was very helpful, because I would go over and watch the videos, and I would get my answers that might pop up during time. I'd get it off right off the video. I didn't need a call. Right. But knowing he was there was very, very comforting kind of thing. Maybe others have. I guess Mary Lee's had a question she wasn't allowed to get access to. That is very disturbing. And it takes off the positive elements that I said, it's a net plus, and now I'm thinking, maybe it's not a net plus anymore if we're being kind of cut off.
I don't think it's the NHMA that's cutting you off.
No, it's not.
So why blame NHMA?
I'm not blaming them. What I'm saying is that their ability to deliver all those pluses.
Yeah, but I mean, his thing was he was told not to only deal with certain people.
Well, I didn't know that, but I tried clarifying with counsel, and that got nowhere as well.
I think this all is in the thing. We all got to get along, whether you're budget committee, selectmen, school board, or precinct. Y'all have to work together because it's Hampton.
I appreciate that, but the selectmen chopped us off. That didn't sound like a very nice thing to
well,
do.
Well, then I'd go and talk to the selectmen.
Well, that's why we have a selectman's rep. We're talking to him now.
Selectman's rep here.
And he's saying, gee whiz, anybody but here tonight.
But Jenny, just to be clear, I'm not blaming the NHMA. What I am saying is that the value added that they did bring to us is has been lessened by a consequence not of their own making.
Right.
Okay? So I'm not blaming them. All right? But the only action the budget committee can take is either to fund or not fund. Or underfund or something to that effect. All we can do is affect the fund. That is to say, the funding mechanism. And so that's all we can do, is consider the funding mechanism in that context. And so that's why I bring it up. I'm not beating up on NHMA.
Okay, Mr. Henderson has a question.
I guess my question is going to be is why was there another layer added to the budget committee? I mean, in the past, okay, I'm sure I've watched some of this, and with some of us in there, we have questions, okay? So we would go to the board chair, and then she would relay that to the NHMA. Now we have this, like, you know, well, we have to come to you. Well, we have to specifically advise, you know, what we want for an answer before, or what we want for a question before we go forward. The town pays for the NHMA as a service. You would think that it would be eligible, you know, to everybody. I mean, just like when I was working at the PD, running union business and things like that, I had access to call the NHMA and ask them questions on different things, you know. And it just seems like there's another layer here that doesn't need to be done. If there's a question that needs to be answered by members of the board, we go to our chair, the board would go to the NHMA, and we get an answer on it. You know? Why add another bureaucracy? And I agree with Jenny, we're all trying to work together. You know, that's what we're all here for, you know.
And they demanded that Channel 22 be turned off.
Well, that's a different topic.
No, it's not a different topic.
That was NHMA, I believe, that did that.
What?
NHMA is the one that
did
that.
Yes, they did. And they said because they represented the selectmen and they weren't going to give any legal advice on camera, and they gave no legal advice whatsoever. Well, but that's another story.
My question is, why did we add another layer?
Yeah.
If that could be answered.
Well,
I'd have to go back and
solve it. And the selectmen can't account for what the NHMA...
And I'll have to go back and look and see why we did that. I can't answer that off the cuff.
Yeah. Okay, we have...
You said you're going to go back and look at it. When might we get a response?
Oh, it'll probably take... either Regina will bring it back to you, or... But as soon as I can look at it, I'm not going to give you an uneducated answer. I'm not going to...
Can we have that by Thursday?
The layer is the proposal there. It almost seems like what it appears to be. Hopefully it's not. Cut people out. It's actually going in front of the selectmen all the time. I think you're paying to you people if people wanted to ask you and they had the advantage of going before. It doesn't seem to make any positive sense, but it's interpreted as being negative. Does that make sense to you, what I just said?
I can understand what you're saying, but I'm not going to answer your question until I can look at it.
Yeah.
You give me a chance to look at it first.
Thank you, Russ.
Can we ask?
Okay,
I'll try to do the best I can.
Madam Chair,
I'll do the best I can.
Thank you.
I'll do the best I can.
Where we're at presently then with this is we can leave it in and we can't touch it again unless someone brings it up in public hearing.
We can.
Or we can take it out and we can't touch it again unless someone brings that up in public hearing.
We're still doing final review Thursday night.
No, we're doing final review
we have a rule.
And Thursday night.
Right.
But you have the right to say your piece at the deliberative session. I have a bottom line total, 2017, for municipal insurance, $3,838,501.
Can I get a statement from Christy, perhaps, or town manager, about the accuracy of the actual insurance numbers here? Are they all, like, solid estimates? I mean, are they quotes or what?
Is that the same total you have, Christy?
Yeah,
that's
the same total that I have.
Okay.
Our life insurance rates are set, they're based on salaries, so when there's changes in salary, that number does fluctuate. So basically, it's all the salaries in the budget were used multiplied by the rate to get that number. Liability and workers' compensation are the quotes that we did receive from Primex. Those are the quotes there. And then health insurance is based on all of the current employees, the plans that there are, any known changes that I was aware of. If I knew someone was pregnant and going to have a child and would be upgraded to a family, I did incorporate that.
Right.
into these numbers. And any empty or vacant position, I think there was a couple at fire and maybe one at Public Works at the time, we always have just assumed a two-person plan for that position just to be safe. We don't assume they're going to be a family, but we also don't want to assume that they're going to be single. So that would be one of the assumptions that was made on the health insurance line, would be for any vacant positions.
When you say the life insurance is based on salary, you mean full-time salary, right?
Yes.
With one exception.
The life insurance, yes, the salary, and then the town manager is included in also,
right,
with that number.
So there's one part-timer that's included in that.
And police specials.
And police specials, yes. Which are
in their contract, according to their contract.
According to their contract, right.
Okay.
So it's full-time contracts, union contracts, and one part-time of the assistant town manager.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
We have a bottom line, $3,838,501. Who made the motion? Mr. LaBranche made the motion.
Mr. Moore seconded.
Okay, you understand the intent. In favor of finalizing this figure under municipal insurance to go to the public hearing. Okay, unanimous.
Madam Chair,
yes.
I'd like to make a motion for debt service.
And debt service is the last tab in the back, the yellow tab.
$2,476,549.
There's really nothing to say here other than to point out that it's merely, in common term, principal and interest payments on various debt.
Yes.
Debt service, so let's vote.
Yes.
Call for a vote, madam.
Wait one second. Who seconded?
Mr. Henderson.
Mr. Henderson.
What was the final number?
$2,476,549.
Thank you.
And the money to pay for the 3 mechanical packers, the 6 trailers, and the initial group of carts from 5 years ago has been paid off in 2016. Therefore, that part of the debt service has been removed. In favor of the motion on debt service to finalize this figure.
Can I make an observation? Yeah, I see. I'd like to make an observation if I could on this. Because I just noticed something that's totally irrelevant, so I'll shut up.
All right, I'll make a motion, Madam Chair.
We've got to hit the Board of Selectmen under executive.
You just said you're going to.
I'll second.
And then we have two.
I'm going to make a motion for the Board of Selectmen salaries.
Yes.
Of $16,300.
Actually, salaries and expenses, to be technical.
Salaries and expenses.
Shouldn't we wait to get an answer on that? Just kidding.
Who seconded you, Steve?
I did.
Mr. Jones seconded. You understand the intent of the motion?
Very simple.
$16,300.
Sure. It's unanimous.
Hands? Yes. Now, I have a couple of things for you because I have.
Can we do the town clerk and some of the others that we did miss? I don't think they need to be.
Well, we can do them.
I don't want to jam up tomorrow night, anyway.
We can.
Thursday night, sorry.
There we go. If they choose not to show up, we will just do those very quickly. That's the town clerk, tax collector, zoning board, library.
Okay, that's fine.
But we should be able to do those very quickly. Christy handed me.
I would like to make a motion for the town clerk, total amount $237,934.
Madam Chair, you've already decided not to do those.
No,
Brian objects to doing.
If
Brian objects to doing them.
If he objects, I share his objection.
If you've told the town employees that you're going to discuss it,
I told
Thursday.
Everybody on this list was notified.
It's supposed to be tonight.
Continue on.
You can read the list.
Because
there's a separate list.
I didn't get the list, but that's okay.
What was that figure?
It was again, 237,934.
Who's seconding? Mr. Fluff. Oh, second.
Mr. Henderson
okay,
seconded.
Okay, you understand the intent, and the figure is down from last year because there are not as many elections.
What was the figure again?
17.
It's 237.
934.
Thank you.
In favor?
And I'll point out that it's town clerk voter registration and election administration.
Okay.
All three of those.
Okay, in favor, unanimous.
Madam Chair, I'd like to make a motion for the tax collector's budget of $103,997.
Okay. Mr. Henderson seconds. That's the tax collector's
budget. Can you run that number by me again?
103,997.
Thank you.
Okay. You understand the intent. In favor?
Abstain.
Everyone is in favor of platform.
So BS for.
We have.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
The second one.
Mr. Henderson seconded.
Mr. Henderson seconded. Mr. Jones abstained. Everyone else is in favor.
Madam Chair, I'd like to make a motion for the zoning board budget of $155,910. Whoops. I'm sorry, Madam Chair, I stand corrected. I would like to make a motion for the zoning board for $5,810.
No.
Thank you, Christy.
Is it near that happens?
I didn't circle that because it looked a little funny. Okay.
Mr. Henderson seconds.
So 155,979?
Yes, no.
5810.
Oh, that's combined. The total. That's right. Subtotal zoning board, 5810.
Thank you.
Madam Chair.
Wait a minute. Mr. LeBranch was trying to move zoning board only, 5810.
Discussion.
Wait a minute. I want a second. Mr. Anderson seconded. Okay.
Madam Chair, the zoning board
budget
of something less than $6,000
is
peanuts compared to the effort that board puts in. Like the planning board staff with personnel like us who receive zero in pay and spend an inordinate amount of time that are not on camera working in addition to a considerable amount of time on camera. So kudos to them. If that's all they need, I'm happy to give them even more if they needed it.
Okay, you understand the intent. Moved by Mr. LeBranch, seconded by Mr. Henderson, to approve the zoning board budget. In favor?
Unanimous.
Unanimous. Okay, and the last one we have.
Madam Chair, I'd like to make a motion for the library budget for $856,588.
Can we finish off the planning and zoning while we're on that?
We did planning.
I didn't do planning and zoning.
We did planning separately.
We don't need to do aggregates.
Madam Chair, do I have a second on my motion?
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Plouffe.
Seconded. Now, you notice that the sick leave and health insurance and so forth is incorporated in the library. Because that does not go through the town office. The library has its own function. Okay, 856588 for 2017. The library.
Just a minute. I haven't got there yet.
21.
Way in the back. Library is way in the back, way down.
Okay, what was the number again?
856588.
Okay. In favor of approving that budget to go to the public hearing on the 12th of January. Favor? Brian, what are you doing? Brian, okay. Wait a minute, because I've got to get this down for Barbara. Bridal, Russell, Pierce, Kravitz, Henderson, Woolsey, Clough.
Why are you opposed, Brian?
Augustine, Marr. And Buckley and
LeBranch. Part-time wages too high?
Opposed?
Opposed.
Okay. Opposed.
This is
Mr. Lapwood.
I'll join Brian.
Opposed is Mr. Lapwood and Mr. Jones. Everyone else is in favor. Now, before you get too frisky or friskier, Christy handed me a private petition. gentleman, Mr. Christie handed me a private petition article that we need to review tonight. We thought we were through with the petition articles, but this one came in. I'm going to pass these around.
They can come in until the 9th of January.
It was, I guess, submitted today. And it's the annual Christmas parade, so it's not some big shocker. So get those around the table if you would.
This experience, Hampson coming in again?
On petition of John Nyan and at least 25 Hampton registered voters, shall the town of Hampton raise and appropriate $3,000 to pay to Experience Hampton, Inc., the organizer of the 2010 to 2016 Hampton Christmas Parades, to help defray the expenses of the 2017 Christmas Parade and related activities, majority vote required. And the fiscal impact is 0.1 cent per $1,000 valuation.
As read?
Mr. LaBranch is moving as read. We need to get this down to the other side here, folks. I'll have the whole there.
Madam Chair, shouldn't we invite the petitioner in to discuss this?
No.
Oh, he's going to be treated differently
than others. Mr. LaBranch is moving. It's a special money article, and this will go to the public hearing. Seconded by Mr. Henderson.
Mr. Henderson seconded.
And I have a question.
I thought we already had this in the budget.
No, it's not in the budget. This is a special money article.
It's a special warrant article.
It's always a special warrant article.
I know we always have, but I just remember it's discussing this.
No, never been in the budget. Never.
No, it's always.
Used to be?
Always been.
I think many years ago.
Well, there stopped being a Christmas parade, so it didn't have a warrant article.
The Experience Hampton is a new
in the last several years, we've had this warrant article.
I don't know the form of that, but I just thought, and with no time to look.
Well, we just got these tonight. Now, the final.
We used to come with all the warrant articles.
Yes.
And the petitioners were all welcome to come and speak to us. But apparently this year, we're not going to welcome this petitioner to come and speak to us.
They submitted it after the other warrant articles.
We have time tomorrow night. We could welcome them tonight to come come Thursday night.
You understand the intent.
Don't you understand about the Christmas parade, Tim?
I didn't say I didn't understand.
No, everybody has to.
I just simply say we should treat everyone equally.
Come in and genuflect to the budget committee.
You know, with liberty for all.
We've done it. Always waiting for after the final day.
You're suggesting a liberty parade?
Well, equality is part of the liberty equation.
The deadline is not here yet for private petition articles, but I think out of courtesy, Christie brought this in so that we could dispose of it. Now, we have a motion on the floor, Mr. LaBranch and Mr. Henderson, for the special warrant article, $3,000, to fund the Hampton, our share of the Hampton Christmas Parade. In favor? Bridle, Russell.
Unanimous.
Whoops, everybody over there.
Unanimous.
Now, do not run away. I'm going to take a motion to adjourn, and we will get together again on Thursday to do the balance of the budget. The public hearing for January 12th has been submitted to the news media, and that has been posted, or will be posted in the press. Now, I have copies, since you voted at the beginning of this meeting, to allow the budget committee to get a copy and to have public recognition of the term, the engagement letter with counsel, that being Mr. Gould of Cleveland Waters and Bass. I have a copy for each of you, and I would like you to come up, if you will, or these are three pages, so we can pass these out to you. So you wait a minute, I've got to separate the student things too.
That's all three pages.
I didn't have a chance to staple it. The phone went crazy all day. Okay. How many more do we need?
One more.
That's the one.
Is that your copy, Rusty?
Rusty, give his.
You have your copy?
Yes.
Okay, then I will accept a motion to adjourn at what hour?
I'll make a motion to adjourn at 9.04 p.m.
Second. Okay. Seconded by Mr. Lapham. And please do this.
Did you want to call
Barbara? Gentlemen, we can't hear with all the side conversations. Barbara emailed the December 8th.
Yes.
This morning at 10:51 a.m. Yes, I got it.
Email the December 8th minutes. Please review those before Thursday night because I'm going to call for a motion to approve those minutes Thursday.
Chair?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I have one of those, ma'am?
December
6th? Is there another one?
December 8th is what you sent me today.
I just have mailed December 8th.
I thought we took care of that, but I'll check my... I will.